Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Our project title is An Energy Efficient Cross Layer Network Operational Model for IEEE 802.15.4 Based Mobile Wireless Sensor Networks. Now we are going to discuss about abstract for this project. In mobile wireless sensor network, the end-to-end data communication is needed to collect the data from source to destination. The collected data are transmitted in the path consists of connected links. All existing end-to-end routing proposing a problem in the case of opportunistic network is continuously changing the network topography. Connection are not stable. Nodes depends on intermediate nodes to send the messages to the destination. Selection of appropriate relay node is quite difficult. The proposed protocol is called AOMDV with the fitness function is called FFAOMDV. The fitness function with ad hoc on demand distance vector routing protocol selecting the routing based on the minimum hop count by using the fitness function. The fitness function is used to finding the optimal path from the source node to the destination node to reducing the energy consumption in multiple routing. The selection of the best routing node is energy is an important constraint. This process is considered the maximum net energy neighboring for the routing the packet. So the messages in the communication is very easy way to the destination. For the performance evaluation, the packet delivery ratio, throughput, network lifetime, delay and the energy consumption per packet metrics were analyzed using the NS2 simulator by varying the energy range. The observed results proved that there is a substrate increasing the packet delivery ratio and decreasing the delay and the energy consumption per packet. In this process, we are using the NS-ALINE-1 2.34 package. This is our flow diagram for this project. First one is on a network formation. In this network formation, we are creating the nodes. In that simulation work has been done within the network simulator NS2. In that package version is 2.34, the network formation is as per the creation of a node network and transmitting the data. Here we are using the Amni antenna model direction. In that Amni antenna direction model is used to covering a 360 degree angle in that communication. Next one is a link layer. Here we are using the FFAOMDV protocol. First we finding the each node position and the fitness function. In that fitness function is used to finding the node position, velocity, speed and the energy for each node and at the each every simulation timing. Next one is now finding the neighbor discovery process. In the neighbor discovery process, finding the distance between the each node in the network and the optimal path finding algorithm is an optimization algorithm is used to propose the method of constructing and the optimal path between the source and the destination. In the FFAOMDV, selecting the routing based on the minimum hop count using the fitness function, and the fitness function is used to finding the optimal path from the source to the destination to node to reducing the energy consumption in the multipath routing. For selection the based routing, the mode energy is important constraint. This process consider maximal network energy neighbor for the routing the packet, so the messages communication is very easy to the destination. In this, such as a node checking the neighbor hop to transmitting the sender data toward the destination to finding the next hop, routing request messages send to all the nodes, routing request is sent to all the intermediate node between the source and the destination. Finally, we calculating the performance evaluation, the packet delivery ratio, throughput, network lifetime, delay and the energy consumption per the packet metrics are analyzed using the NS2 simulator by varying the energy range. Now I am going to run our project. This is our terminal window. Here we type cd space code. This command is used to change the directory. Cd means change directory. Here we change the root directory into ஒரு கோடு. இந்த டைப் nsspace main dot tcl discount is used to run our main dot tcl file. Here we find each node position and updated energy. This is NAM console and this is out.NAM window. Here we create a 100 node dynamic manner, so each time a node location will change. Now I am click the play button. The neighbor node estimation is done here and each node in more random mobility model. So the source and destination is created, the data will send. Communication is start between 4 and 20 node. 4 is a source node and 20 is a destination node. Next source and destination is 5. Now the 5th node is a source and destination is 45. Here we optimal path is found and the data is transmitted. Now the 7th node is source and the 49th node is a destination. This is RTS message. This is acknowledgement message and this is CTS message. RTS means ready to send, CTS means clear to send, and the acknowledgement message is after the data transmission, the destination node sends the acknowledgement to the source node. And the black color dotted lines indicates the TCP connection between the source and the destination, and here we 1040 bytes are transmitted. Here neighbor node.tr file is dynamically generated. So this is neighbor node file and then routing table is dynamically generated. And fitness values is calculated here. Each node position, velocity, speed and energy is calculated and printed in fitness.txt file. Finally, performance measures. Here we find the delay, energy, network lifetime, and packet delivery ratio and throughput. Now I am running the graph. First one is a delay dot plot. Now I am going to run the graph. First one is a delay graph. So type GNU plot delay dot plot. This command is used to run our delay graph in the project. We are comparing with an existing system. Our process delay is low. In this graph, x-axis indicates the time in millisecond and the y-axis indicates the delay versus. And then red color line indicates the existing system values and green color line indicates the proposed system value. And now I am run next graph. It's network lifetime dot plot. Network lifetime dot plot. So the network lifetime is increased based on the remaining energy and PDR graph, PDR dot plot. So this is packet delivery ratio. Our packet delivery ratio is high when comparing with an existing system. Thank you for listening. Our demo is completed. Thank you.